joy to the world. Do you want to be truly happy, to experience real joy? You need to remove the poison in your life. Yes, you need to remove the poison in your life. You need to take away the poison of selfishness. To stress this point, let me tell you a story. Once a group of 150 people was attending a seminar. Suddenly the speaker stopped and decided to do a group activity. He started giving each person a balloon. Each one was asked to write his or her name on it using a marker pen. Then all the balloons were collected back and put into another room. Next, they were let in the room and asked to find the balloon that had their name on it within 5 minutes. Only 5 minutes. Everyone was frantically searching for their balloons with their names on it, colliding into each other's arm, pushing around each other, and there was utter chaos. At the end of 5 minutes, not a single person could find their own balloon. The speaker asked everyone to go back to the room after 5 minutes and told them that they're going to do the same activity again, but they need to change one thing. This time, they are not going to find their own balloon. Everyone was asked to randomly collect a balloon and give it to the person whose name was written on it. And look what happened. Within 2 minutes, everyone had their own balloons. As the room was filled with laughter and self-satisfaction and delight. The balloon symbolizes one's happiness. This is exactly what's happening in all our lives. Everyone is desperately looking around for happiness, but no one knows where to find it. Instead of searching your own balloon, you help someone find theirs. This is something so beautiful and so precious to remember, that if you try to find your own balloon, if you try to find your own happiness, you might not be able to find it. But if you help others find happiness in their lives, eventually, without any doubt, you will overflow with not just happiness, but with unspeakable joy. Praise God. You see, our happiness lies in the happiness of other people. Give them their happiness, their balloons, and in return, you will get your own. Wow, that's amazing, isn't it? Glory to God. Our verse for today is found in John chapter 2, where it tells us about our Lord's cleansing of the temple. John chapter 2, verse 16 says, to those who sold the doves, he said, take these things away from here. Do not make my Father's house a marketplace. What has the temple cleansing tells men and women like us today? The temple Jesus visited in Luke chapter 2 was a kind of place it should have been, a place to worship God and to study His Word. John chapter 2 verse 16 tells us that we should not make God's temple a marketplace. And in view of these conditions, the Holy Temple, intended as a house of prayer for all people, had become a den of robbers, as found in Jeremiah chapter 7 verse 11 and Mark 11 17. Those who attempted to bring their own sacrificial animals had them rejected by the temple priest, and thereby were forced to purchase approved animals at much higher price. there was so much corruption and selfishness during those times. You see, in the temple during those times, there was monopoly. There was so much corruption and selfishness. What Jesus sees going on in the temple courts troubled him a great deal. The place of prayer had become a marketplace. The temple Jesus finds nearly 20 years later seems to have greatly changed. There was corruption and selfishness, and thus the need for its cleansing. In 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19 to 20, Jesus asks, "Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God? You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body." Today, Jesus is telling us to cleanse our temple. Take away all the evil ways and thoughts, the laziness, the wrong motives, the wrong priorities, the stubbornness, the self-centeredness, and selfishness in us. Take them all away. Yes, everyone wants to be happy, but to be truly happy, we must allow the Holy Spirit to move in us, to cleanse us, to make us other-centered, to be selfless, always looking for ways to help others. Today, our communities, our country, and the whole world is struck with pandemic and storms, even at the moment. People are living in uncertain times and are full of anxiety, sadness, depression, fear, and worry. As Christians, there are a lot of opportunities today to help others around us. Just look around. When there is hope, there is joy. And the only way for us to be truly happy, to find real joy, is to fill our lives with God's unconditional love and share that love to others to make them experience real happiness and true joy in our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the hope we have in you amid our present circumstances and life uncertainties. Fill us with your presence and move in our lives through the Holy Spirit, that we may be inspired to share your love to others, which eventually will fill us with your unspeakable joy and heavenly peace. Bless us to be a blessing to others as we spread joy to the world. In Jesus' powerful name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you very much once again, my dear family and friends, for listening today. Join me again next time. This is Sess. God bless you.